Hi my friends, when repairing Antminer hash boards, if an ASIC chip is damaged or burnt out, we need to replace it promptly. The correct replacement method can shorten the repair time. In this process, we will need some specific tools for this job. This ASIC chip is faulty, and today we will use its replacement as an example to demonstrate the correct and quick repair method. Step 1. Clean the residual solder paste impurities. Step 2. Use a hot air gun to remove the heat sink from the back of the faulty chip, setting the temperature to about 450 degrees Celsius, with a wind speed of about 4 gear. Step 3. Remove the chip. We can use flux to help us quickly remove the chip, while retaining the solder paste on the pad pins. After removal, we will see that the solder paste on the pads is uneven. Just use the soldering iron to melt and make it as neat as possible. Then clean the pads again. Step 4. Use a tinning module to plant tin on the pins of the new chip. Then heat and melt the solder paste. Notice, this process only takes a few seconds, otherwise, it will damage the chip. After completion, we need to ensure that each pin is covered with solder paste, and that there is no bridging. Step 5. Solder the new chip in place. Ensure the correct polarity. A small area here is positive pole, and another part is negative pole. First of all, correctly place it on the pads. Then add flux and start soldering. Keep the heat gun settings the same as when we took the old chip off. During soldering, the tweezers can gently press down on the chip. When the solder on the pin starts to shine, we can slowly stop heating. Afterwards, clean the chip and its surroundings again. The last step is all about checking the soldering work. Look over the chip's pins on both sides. No solder bridges, and the solder on each pin is full. Then, measure the ground values for the signals on both sides of the chip. Set the multimeter to diode gear, and compare the readings to a normal hash board. At last, we need to reinstall the heat sink, keeping the heat gun settings the same as when we removed them. Okay, that's the method and steps for replacing an ASIC chip. If you have questions, feel free to leave a message. Thanks, everyone.